Well, hello, my darlings, and welcome back to our channel. I am so glad you are here. Today, I am going to show you how you can use a few items from the dollar store to create an elegant piece, the foundation of which will only cost you $4. I sure hope you'll stay tuned. For this project, you will need 2 hula hoops, spray painted silver. You will also need 2 of these foam rings. You will need a light if you so choose to light your centerpiece. You will of course need some florals, some greening pins, and you will need a few long strands of crystal garlands. Of course, you will need your handy dandy tools. Let's get crafting. The first thing we're going to do for this craft is separate our hula hoops into halves. And I'm going to show you how we're going to get this done. I have already cut the first of my hula hoops into half, and I'm going to show you how I am going to cut this second one, making sure that I am centering my second cut to where my first cut is. And once you have found your placement, all you're going to do is take a sharp knife or a hand saw, if you will, and cut to make sure that you have 2 equal halves of that hula hoop, 4 equal halves of both of them. Now that we have cut our hula hoops into halves, we are going to line what is going to become the base of our centerpiece. And to do this, I'm simply taking my black felt and I am outlining the outside of that foam so that I can go in with my scissors and cut out where I have etched. As you can see here, you can see where the pen just made a raised indentation of where I need to cut that felt. And then of course that would be the outside measurement. And then to get the inside measurement, if you want to make sure that your middle is hollow just as your piece, you go in once again with your pen, trace it, and then you can go ahead and cut the entire shape out. Once you have cut the entire shape out, you're going to apply some hot glue and set your black felt cutout into place. So now that we have lined the bottom of our centerpiece with our black felt, we are now going to start our build-up process. And to do this, we're going to use 2 halves of our hula hoop that we cut previously, and we are going to embed these 2 halves into our floral foam. Now what I'm doing here is simply taking the 2 halves and I am making an etching, one on either side of my foam, to see exactly where I am going to want that hula hoop to be anchored, or where I should say that hula hoop to be anchored. Once I have found my placement, I'm going to place my hula hoop in the space, push it in just a little bit more, take my hot glue, place a layer of hot glue right on top of the etching that we made, and then place that half of that hula hoop inside the foam, allowing it to set and to dry for a few moments. Now, for video purposes, I'm going to go straight into my second half of my hula hoop, going in, applying my glue, on top of that indentation, and then placing my hula hoop in its place, and then allowing both of them to set for a few moments. But if you are creating this at home, my darlings, I very humbly suggest that you glue one of these one at a time before you glue the others. Off camera, I am going to attach my top ring, and once those pieces have been set into place, I will return. So here we have the first stage of our centerpiece in place. And if you notice, you can see that the left side of this hula hoop is a little rounder than the right side of the hula hoop. And the reason for this, after I took some time to figure it out, was because I took two left shoes, if you're understanding my analogy, or two left sides of a hula hoop and put them together as opposed to using a left and a right. So just make sure that when you're doing this, once you have cut your hula hoops into halves, you keep them separated one from another so that you will have one right side and one left side. And so as you can see I'm doing here, I'm simply repeating this process using my two halves of a hula hoop to make the indentations that I'm going to need to find my placement. And once I have done that, taking my hot glue, placing the hot glue over the indentation, and then placing the hula hoops into its place, top and bottom, and allowing it to set and dry for a few moments. So here you can see we have the structure of our centerpiece almost completely finished. And what I'm going to show you here now is how we are going to start to attach our crystals to our piece. Now, initially, I thought the crazy glue would have worked for this section or this part of the project where I am gluing on my crystal garlands to my plastic hula hoop. However, the crazy glue worked on the one part that you see hanging already, the anchor, but then when I tried it again on this piece that I'm showing you here, it did not work. And so what I would suggest that you do is use your high heat glue gun to place bullets of that hot glue onto your hula hoop and then setting that crystal into place and allowing it to set for a few moments. So what I'm going to do is continue placing my crystal garlands. I think I'm going to do 1, 2, 3, perhaps 4 strands all the way around. And then once I have done that, I am going to come back to show you how we are going to embellish this piece even further. So here we have our magical pumpkin that is on its way to complete with the embellishments that we are putting into place. And as you can see, as I promised, I placed 4 strands of our crystal garland around the entirety of our centerpiece. Now what I'm doing here is I'm going in with some greening pins and I am placing some of the crystal garlands that have been dressed with a crystal pendant hanging at the bottom, and I'm going in with my greening pin and I am putting those crystal pendants and garlands into place. I have cut some of them longer than the other so that you can get topsy-turvy or an asymmetrical rather look about our hanging crystal garlands and pendants. Then I initially thought that I was going to take our push light, place some flowers around the base of our piece, and then put the push light in the middle. However, while I was working, I thought of using the mirror that I just placed down there in the bottom of our centerpiece to give this piece an added touch of elegance. However, my darlings, like I say in almost all of my videos, however you chose to embellish this piece will be entirely up to you. Once I have placed my mirror, it is now time to go ahead and start to create my floral arrangement by covering both of my foams with the red roses that I'm going to be using for this piece. Once I have done that, I'm going to clean up our centerpiece, remove any glue fronds there are. I'm going to stage our piece, and then I will return to show you, what our finished project looks like. Well, here you have it, my darlings, Cinderella's Magic Pumpkin. Is this not just absolutely gorgeous? Listen, I will be 100% transparent with you guys when I tell you that this was not my initial vision. As a matter of fact, the crystal garlands that you see that we have draped all around this piece was not the way I envisioned the crystal garlands looking. Suffice it to say, my initial plan did not work, and that plan is now sitting on a back burner somewhere waiting to be revisited. But I have to say that I am pleased that plan one did not work, and plan two, as you can see, is now in full effect. And so if anyone were to ask me what, Miss Danielle, would be your favorite part of this project, my answer would have to be the draping of those crystals. This piece under full light is absolutely gorgeous, and possibly a little later in the outro, you will see that this piece, even in natural light, is equally as gorgeous. And so, my darlings, if you have found any value in this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up, as well as leave me a comment in the comment section below. Let me know, what is your favorite part of this centerpiece, and what, if anything, would you be placing on the mirrored base? I would love to hear from you. To my Danny's darlings, I just would like to take this time to thank you for your questions, your comments, your feedback, but most of all, my darlings, for your encouragement. Please know that none of it is wasted, and I appreciate each and every one of you more than you will ever know. To those of you, however, who are not yet Danny's darlings, we would like to humbly encourage you to join our ever-growing community of DIYers as we learn from and craft with each other on a weekly basis. And if you so decide to subscribe to our channel today, also be sure to ring the notification bell, click all notifications, so that you will be made aware whenever any of our videos are published, as well as whenever we go live as a community. Well, my darlings, before I sign off of today's video, I am going to leave you with the motto to our channel, which is simply this. Say it with me. Why buy when you can DIY? And so, my darlings, my loves, until next time, I say to you, please, 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 take care of yourselves for me, and know that I love you all. Bye now.
If you're impressed with what you see, feel free to like and subscribe.